definitely do feel pressure to write the next record that's killer. And it definitely has been something that I've actually been struggling with a fair bit.
It's a hurdle for every artist to do a second record. That's a step that in their heads, they have to get past.
The first one, what I felt, I just wrote it. This one's been a much different experience because I've now got music out and people have an expectation and there's pressure from many different angles.
I mean, we talked about it, Nathan and I.
We have some deadlines for Harley that we kind of need to figure out, and we needed to talk to him about what they were, because if we don't sort of tell him what they are, then he's not getting the full amount of information that he needs to be empowered and in control of his career and his life. But if we do tell him, it's reality that bursts a sort of creative bubble.
If there's any kind of thought process that goes on outside of the music, any anxiety or anything, it completely blocks the creativity. I wrote a lot of the last record when I was traveling. I started out with, you know, a couple of $1,000, and I was in these foreign countries for the first time. I feel like I'm just here just to make this thing. It's been so consuming. I've done that to myself, you know, it's me, just, I put a lot of pressure on myself for things, especially this. I'm kind of my own worst enemy. I wish I could just write, but I actually need to be inspired by things. And coming to LA for the first time was super inspiring. We're getting all these really alien. So then I can be like, is it, hey? It's always important to try and find, for me, it's important to always have new textures and new sounds, because everyone has the same gear, but it's all about using the gear in the way it's not supposed to be used. Now what I realize is that I can't have a routine and write and go into a studio and sit down and just go, okay, I'm gonna write from 9 to 5. I can't do that. That's just not the way my brain works. I have to be traveling, or I have to be writing in places that I shouldn't be writing, whether it's in the back of a van on the way to some desert festival in the middle of nowhere. I just have to be stimulated and be in different environments and have new things going on and maybe feeling a bit out of whack because I'm in a new time zone. It's those situations where I find the best ideas come about.
So Harley had an empty house and an empty studio, and yet he turns up in our living room when there are 4 children running around and a bunch of random grown-ups. It was absolute chaos, and he's like, I'm just gonna work here.
So what I'm trying to do is essentially recreate a bit of grit in my life for inspiration. I kind of want to just go somewhere really basic, put myself in the deep and put myself in situations where I might have to sleep in my car or on the floor somewhere, you know?
I was at the studio with Harley like an hour ago. He's flying to Mexico tomorrow. He wants some time out.
Maybe not do the next show.
That literally happened an hour ago.
Yeah, so I'm gonna get a drink. So San Bernardino is an odd place.
But in this rehearsal precinct at the moment yesterday, LCD Sound System was in the next warehouse. Apparently Fleetwood Mac's over there, so Chad and I are going to duck our heads in and see if we can check that out.
On the stage, will this be the specs? So, like, that going to be behind me, or are they going to be above me?
Yeah, I grew a mustache for Mexico. I was celebrating Mexico. I was just going a little crazy, trying to get things done, and went to Mexico, wrote some really great stuff, went there for 5 days, went surfing, hung out, got food poisoning, and then what have I been doing since? God, well, the record's done now, so that's awesome. I feel like my mental space is being cleared so I can focus on the show, I can focus on the visual content, I can focus on how the lights look, bits and pieces, everything that's not the music.
I got a call from, or an email I should say, from Jay at a really early stage before a lot of the music was ready.
We'd been talking for some time about who would do the design for the new album campaign. It really needed to have its own new look and feel. Jonathan is an amazing artist and designer. I knew that Harley really responded well to his images and that his images had informed a lot of the live show material.
I'd been working on a little project which were these sort of 3D flowers that sort of have some unreal and surreal elements in them in terms of the coloration and the texturing. That sort of playing and chopping and changing between these hard metallic fake materials like car paint and these sorts of impossible things, adding those to the natural beauty of a flower petal felt more and more a perfect match to Harley's music. He would start with something that was beautiful and then chopping it up and making it a little more aggressive or fuck it up a little bit, make it feel a little less comfortable. I think that's what the flowers were doing.
Jonathan is, he is like, I couldn't think of a better person for the job. I love what he does. I love his aesthetic. I feel like a lot of the stuff he does almost feels like it should be ugly, but it's not for some reason, just because he's got such an amazing eye for design. I don't even know what he does, but whatever he does, is I love it.
Spending time with him has really helped me get a feel for the more of the subtleties that he's interested in. Realising those things has allowed me to feel confident to explore them a little further than I would have otherwise if we didn't have the kind of close relationship that we have. I developed a concept for Smoke and Retribution, which were just these single images of these weapons rendered kind of fantastically and in unreal textures and materials and colours and things like that. We were chatting about it and I was saying I'd love to animate some for something, and he was like, oh, that'd be great, I'll make some music for that. He went off and just made these little mini songs and sent them back to me, and then I animated the existing stuff to that, and then he kind of responded again to those and made some more music components to that. It became a much less linear kind of start and stop process. Getting to work on artwork that goes along with that, while it's a living, growing thing, it feels so much more creatively compelling to me. My Instagram's completely been taken over by Flume fans, so I'm terrified of it now.